Assalamu alaikum, my beloved brothers and sisters. This evening in Salat al-Isha, I read verses of Surah al-Isra, and one of them actually really, really touched my heart. Not that the verses of the Quran don't touch my heart, but sometimes, you know, something strikes you and you start thinking about it, and it definitely, you know, makes a difference, and it creates a different type of an impact. And today was one of those days where, subhanAllah, I thought I'd just share with you something very, very unique. You know, when we get wealth, and we become very, very wealthy, sometimes the more we have, the more miserly we actually become. The more we have, the more miserly we become. Yet the mercy of Allah is great. When we don't have, it's a problem. When we have, it's a problem. When we're getting, it's a problem. And when we're not getting, it's a problem. For us, almost everything is a problem. Where are those whom the more they get, the more generous they become? Yes, I'm sure they are there. In fact, I do know of some who are very generous. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that He kept the treasures of the earth. He kept the treasures of the earth Himself. The control of these treasures is His own. And He explains it in verse number 100 of Surah Al-Isra in a unique way. He says, قُلْ لَوْ أَنْتُمْ تَمْلِكُونَ خَزَائِنَ رَحْمَةِ رَبِّي. If you say to them that if you had to own, or if you owned the treasures of the mercy of Allah, and here it speaks of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, definitely sustenance is included in it, that which is monetary, that which is the favor of Allah, the bounties of Allah, and it goes way beyond mere sustenance. But if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had given you the ownership of His mercy and the treasures that He had, the ownership of the treasures that of Allah, if had He given you, you would have held back. Subhanallah. إِذَنْ لَأَمْسَكْتُمْ. You would have held back. You wouldn't have spent. You wouldn't have distributed. Imagine today you have a billion, 5 billion, whatever you have. How much do you actually give? Allah says, you know what? It is all ours. It was all ours. It will always be all ours. You will come. You might spend a little bit and you will go. You came with nothing. You go with nothing. It will always be ours. It is ours. And you know what? We gave it and distributed it in a manner that we wanted. We gave it wherever we wanted, however we wanted, in a beautiful way. Those who worship us, those who don't worship us, we gave both of them. Those who have earned our wrath and those who have earned our pleasure, we gave both of them. So Allah's given all sorts of people, all types from everywhere. Imagine if you had to own the sustenance that Allah owns. Even for a moment, people would only give their relatives, their nationality, their color, their race, their type, their continent. People wouldn't give anyone else. And in fact, they wouldn't even give their own family nowadays. This is what we found, that your own family, people don't give their family, their friends, their relatives. They hold back. Their family is struggling. They're multimillionaires. Someone is struggling with $1,000, you know, $10,000. They will not help. So Allah says, that's why we kept it for ourselves. We kept it for ourselves. Because if we gave you that ownership, you would have held back, fearing its depletion. Wow. إِذَنْ لَأَمْسَكْتُمْ خَشْيَةَ الْإِنْفَاقِ وَكَانَ الْإِنسَانُ قَتُورًا. Allah says, man is definitely niggardly. He's stingy. He wants, he's selfish. He wants things for himself. He's not going to give. He's not going to give others. When we don't have, we're sometimes more generous than when we do have. And I've said this again. So remember, what a powerful verse of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says, had we given you the ownership of the treasures of our mercy, you would have held back. You wouldn't have spent. You would have held back fearing its depletion. Allah says, definitely man is very niggardly, very, very selfish. Subhanallah. He thinks of himself, me, myself, and I. That's what it is. So to be able to spend is a gift of Allah. Whatever you have is owned not by you, but by Allah. Remember, He gave it to you. He gave it to you. Are you going to give others? Are you going to spend on others? Are you going to look after others? Are you going to make others comfortable? A little bit, a little bit. Are you going to try and help people around you? Are you going to help as many people, or are you going to keep on amassing and amassing and amassing? You know, the more you have, the more you spend. That's great. But if you were just to amass and you're not spending, then subhanAllah, remember a day will come when you will die and nothing would have benefited you. As Allah speaks about Abu Lahab, ma aghna anhu maluhu wa ma kasab. What a wealthy man, but his wealth and whatever he earned did not help him at all. We don't want to be from among those. When you have, look at others, look at your relatives, look at family, look at those around you, look at your community, look at another community, look at your neighbors, look at those struggling across the globe and keep giving. The more you give, the more you will get. Never has wealth depleted because of charity that is given. That's the statement of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. So with these beautiful words, I leave you with this verse, verse number 100. Of Surah Al-Isra, قُلْ لَوْ أَنْتُمْ تَمْلِكُونَ خَزَائِنَ رَحْمَةِ رَبِّي إِذَا لَأَمْسَكْتُمْ خَشْيَةَ الْإِنْفَاقِ وَكَانَ الْإِنسَانُ قَتُورًا. Tell them, had they owned the mercy or the treasures of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they would have held back, fearing its depletion, for indeed man is definitely very, very selfish, very niggardly, and so on. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with wealth, and may He make us from those whom, when we get it, we spend even more. بارك الله فيكم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد